Hey, welcome back to the Six Figure Mastermind. There are a few key things that every business needs. Google Sheets is one of them, and we're going to go deep into how to edit your Google Sheets today. There's a few key things you want to take some good notes on. In fact, pull up another browser screen so you can edit right along with me. Stay tuned. All right, it's time to get into Google Sheets. The days of Microsoft Excel are still alive and well, but Google Sheets is one that's going to be much more convenient for you when you're trying to share information between two people. If you're using a software on your computer, then you're gonna have, you know, uploads and downloads, and you're gonna have some lag time between when you need to talk to people and when you need the information. Google Sheets solves all of those problems, and it can do most of the thing Microsoft Excel can do much faster and much easier. So what I'm going to have you do is I'm going to have you open up a brand new browser, either over here or top or bottom, wherever you want to go. I would recommend left or right though. The thing you're going to need for a Google Sheets account is a Google email account. So if you don't already have one, get one. Okay, I'm going to walk you through Google Sheets. The beauty about Google Sheets, though, is that even if you don't have a Gmail account, you can still edit and make adjustments to your Google Sheets. You know, if you want to produce them, you're going to have an account. But if someone sends you a Google Sheet and wants you to contribute to that, you don't have to have a Gmail account to do that. Super cool. So if you've got your browser window open, one side or the other, open up your Google Sheets page. If you've got a Gmail account, you can go up here. I'm going to show you my page right here. If you can go up here to this little 9-block square, and you can find your Google Sheets in there. Or you can just go to docs.google.com or Google Drive. Google's really good about redirecting you to where you want to go. Their interface is amazing. Okay, so let's go to a brand new Google Sheets. You've got your sheet set up here, and if you want to start a new sheet, you totally can. I'm going to use a pre-existing one just to kind of show you how to edit and use the text boxes and things like that. But if you wanted to open up a new one, there's templates that are pre-made for you. Check out this template gallery. You've got so many different kinds of templates. You can do a calendar, schedule, you can do a pros and cons, you can do a team roster, wedding planner, all of these different kinds of documents that are what's so cool about these templates is that the formulas are pre-built in. So for example, if you had a employee shift schedule and there was hours that needed to be calculated, you could just put in the hours and the formulas will already be in there, so you don't even have to do any of the legwork. It's pretty awesome. Okay, so let's go to a document that I've already started, and I will show you how to edit this document. Now, this is a document that I have with my friend. We do some jewelry together on the side. We sell it in a consignment store, and we needed to track what products were going to the store, and we needed to track how many of those products, the price of those products, the codes of those products, and all of that needed to be in a readable document, okay? So we put it all in here. Now, I have this document. You can share it with another person, but this is one that I already have shared with my girlfriend, Colleen, and we have this document shared. So anything that I do on this document, she can see on this document live as it's happening right away. And in fact, it's kind of fun when you have you and your collaborators of your document all on the document at the same time. You can kind of see who's doing what and where and by different colors and things like that. So this is, you know, a very, very helpful tool. One of the things that's super helpful in Google Sheets is a comment thread. And you can do this in Google Docs or Google Sheets. If you open up this comment thread, then you'll be able to have a conversation. It'll be left stuck right with the document. So if I were to say, hey, I'm adding a comment here. I'm editing this live on my YouTube channel. Now, if I were to leave that comment on there, Colleen would be able to see that comment is there, and she could comment back and I could read her reply, and it's just like a living text message that just sticks right with the document. And the comment is attached to this cell because this is the cell that I had clicked on. Now, check out this little yellow flag over here. This little yellow flag is where all of those comments for that cell will be stored. So that's pretty important to know. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and resolve that, and that will make that comment go away. Now, let's talk about editing this Google Doc. Now, there's some really cool things that you can do. It's a Google Sheet, excuse me, not a Google Doc. Pretty cool things you can do. Let's say that I needed to have this row stay in place. So right now, when I move this toggle switch right here, if I drag this toggle switch this way, then it's going to not show me the furthest rows to the left. So if you're trying to freeze a column, merge cell as part of that column, so watch what happens. So I've got this title cell up here that has our Limitless Treasures consignment items, and this cell is technically 1, A, B, C, D, E, and F. All of those cells are in one. And if I click on this little, if I right click over here, or triple click if you're using a Mac, and I click this little icon and try it and drag it over, that's going to want to freeze the column, but watch what happens. There was a problem. Sorry, you can't freeze columns which contain only part of a merged cell. Try to break apart the merged cell or freeze more columns to include the complete or merged cells. Now, in my case, this merged cell pretty much covers all of my data. So I'm going to want to unmerge this cell right here. The way I'm going to do that is I'm just going to click on the cell and click this little highlighted box right here. This little highlight box with the arrows pointing toward each other. This is the merged cell box. And if you ever want to know what anything is, just hover over it and leave your mouse there. It's going to give you a description. So if I unmerge the cells, it's going to take this back over to A1 rather than A, B, C, D, E, and F1. And it's going to take this and make it available. So if I were to triple click, or three finger click rather, and it's going to highlight this little block for me, and I'm going to drag it right over here. Boom. Now watch what happens. That cell, that column is now frozen in place. So when I go to move this slide bar right over here, check that out. That data stays right there. And this is really super helpful if you've got a list of clients and maybe you're taking attendance at your events, or maybe you've got their information lined up over here and you're using, maybe you're using Google Sheets as kind of a CRM. Customer relationship management software. It's really helpful to know which client you're dealing with when you're looking through all of the columns of their information. So freezing cells is something I use in almost all of my Google documents just to help me have this easier interface set up. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and unfreeze that cell, and I'm going to re-merge. So I've got this text in this cell right over here on the left, and I need to highlight all of the cells that I want that cell to merge with. So I'm gonna click this, hold down the shift key, and then click all the way to the other cell, and then check this out. When I go up here, I'm gonna click merge cells. Boom, very super, super handy. Now, Google Sheets is great because if I don't like something that I did, I can just click this rewind or undo button and watch what happens. And it'll remember my steps. So if I click undo several times, it's going to remember my history. The same with the redo button. I can say, oh, I actually did want to do that. I'm going to redo that. Google Sheets will remember your history of the adjustments and the edits that you've made. So keep that in mind. Okay, we're just going to walk through this taskbar real quick here. This is your print feature that's going to work with AirPrint or direct line printers. This is the paint format. I never use that. I wouldn't worry about it. Your zoom, this is just going to not affect how things look on the paper, but it's going to affect how things look on your screen. So I just typically keep it at 100%. Okay, right over here, you can format your columns as currency. So if I were to highlight this column right here, and I said, I want that to be formatted as currency, I could click on that. Okay, that would format everything in that column as currency. Now, if I were to do it in this column, watch what happens. I've got letters and numbers in there. It's not going to want to do it for me because obviously that's not a currency form. Okay, I can also format columns as percentages. So if I were to put in, you know, I have another column in here. Let's just, for example, say I want to add a column. I'm going to right click or use two finger click, insert one to the left. I can add a column. And let's say I wanted to put some numbers in here. Now this is auto formatted at a dollar amount, but watch what happens when I highlight this column and I format it as a percentage. It takes it to a percentage, and I can double check and make sure those percentages are where I want by editing it right here in this top bar. So I could say, I don't want it 1000%, I want 10%, okay? You can make all of those adjustments right there, okay? So I'm going ahead and delete this column, by right-clicking or two-finger clicking and then hitting delete column. Beautiful. Okay, so you can decrease or increase decimal places. There's more formatting options if you just surf right through here. Number, percent, scientific, accounting. Numbers, percentage, financial, currency, date, time format, duration, lots of other formats, date and time formats, and currency formats are probably going to be the ones you use most often. And of course, you can change the fonts in these as well. If you highlight one or click shift and highlight all, that's going to change everything that's highlighted. So if I change that to this font, that's what it's going to look like. If I change it to this font, and that's what it's going to look like. And remember, if I don't like it, I can just go back and hit undo. Undo to get it back to normal. So the primary thing to remember when you're working in Google Sheets is that your sheets are going to be edited by the cells that are highlighted. So remember, if I'm changing font type or size or bold, italic, strike through, colors or highlight colors, even borders, it's all going to depend on which cells are highlighted. Now, most of these, if you walk through them, they're extremely self-explanatory. If you want your horizontal alignment to be the left, it's going to look like that. If you want it to be centered, it's going to look like that. If you want it to be to the right, it's going to look like that. Okay? And remember, it's by the cell that's highlighted. A vertical alignment. This is going to align my cells vertically, or the text in my cells vertically. Okay, so if you click here, either with your mouse or with your trackpad, and drag that down, watch what happens. I've got my vertical alignment. I can make it at the top. I can make it at the center, or I can push it all the way down to the bottom. Now, the reason it's moving that entire column is, look, or the entire row, rather, is that the entire row is highlighted. I highlighted this row, okay? I can make it just by one cell by clicking on a single cell and simply doing the same thing, okay? So I'm going to go back, put that where I want it. Very, very good. You can also rotate your text. So let's say you want your text to spill down the column vertically. You can use this text rotator tool to do exactly that. You can make your text go at an angle. You can make your text go vertically, just spill it down. You can make your text go to the side, like the spine on a book, any way that you want. You can even turn it 90 degrees if you want, or 75, or whatever you want it to be. Okay, so I don't typically need to use that, but it is available. Okay, again, you've got hyperlinks. Here's another cool thing about Google Sheets is that you can insert a link. So let's say if I wanted this bracelet to go to my website. Let me just show you what this looks like right here. So I've got my website right here. This is someone else's website that I'm just using, borrowing right now. And if I wanted to link that, I could copy that web link and put that as a link right here. So anything in that text box is going to go to that website. So when I click on this text box, look, it shows that website right there, right above the box. Super handy if you're sending this and sharing this with your colleagues. Okay, we've walked through a majority. Again, you can insert comments, you can insert graphs and charts, you can insert filters, you can insert functions, all of that. We just want to walk through a basic editing of your functions bar right here. Google Sheets, if you spend any amount of time with it, you're going to find more and more and more and more you can do with it. Primary things you need to know: you can edit, you can rewind, you can fast forward in your edits. It keeps a history for you. You can add comments. You can share those comments with anyone that has access to that sheet. And you can share this sheet with anyone on or off Google. Very comprehensive. You're going to love it for your business. Don't be surprised if you find yourself using Google Sheets for everything. Seriously, it's one of the best platforms I have found out there. Hit the subscribe button. Keep watching. We're going to give you more business tips, tricks, and hacks right here on the Six Figure Mastermind.